Hi, this is Shweta here. I was asked a question by one of our executive clients saying that what's the best way to think about creative ideas? How do I make sure that my team and I are engaged with the process and we are thinking absolute blue sky and not just being repetitive or regurgitating what we already know in a different kind of, you know, with a different skin, but actually coming up with some good, proper ideas? I thought the question was brilliant, really good question. And we started thinking about it, we started brainstorming, and actually I talked about a few pointers that he could be mindful of to get the best out of the process. Now, this is what I have learned from different books and workshops and also have applied that in our own businesses. So the first thing is, you might be familiar with this, it's De Bono's six hats process, okay? So if you know about this, I'm not gonna bore you, but it's a great idea if you could just look it up in case you wanna know more about it. It's a very famous process of thinking creative ideas, of really thinking in a holistic, proper way. So basically, this is the thinking rules that one adopts, six thinking rules, and they are symbolized through different colors, and which is your thinking hats. So for example, there's a white color, which means that you're just thinking about the facts. You're discussing facts only. Then there is yellow, which is all about optimism and positivity and, you know, just that energy and how do we think where we can provide value and benefit to people. Then there is black color, which is actually about being devil's advocate. What can go wrong? What are the problems? What obstacles could arise? What are we not seeing that we should be seeing? And then from that color, you're moving on to the red color, which is about your feelings. What does your intuition say? So red is not right at the front. It's later on because you're looking at the facts. You're being devil's advocate. You're thinking about the value and the benefit. And then you're coming to the red color, which is your intuition and feelings. After that, one moves to the green color. This is where the creativity, alternatives, different routes kick in. And finally, there is the blue color or the blue thinking hat, which is actually about the thinking process, the system, which actually keeps all the other colors intact and done in the right way. So that's your De Bono method. And literally in your team meetings, you could say, okay, guys, now we're going to be wearing a white hat and we just talk about the facts. Okay, now we are going to be wearing red hat, and now we're just going to be talking about how we are feeling, what's our intuition saying, right? So there is a structure, a process, the way you're conducting these meetings to think about different ideas. Now, along with that, there is another simple way of thinking about some really, as I said, blue sky ideas, okay, and not just getting limited with your own, I would say, the background or the experience or your identity. And that is, now, instead of brainstorming, which is what we say, right? Let's brainstorm. Instead of brainstorming, you do role-storming. So what does that really mean? So role-storming is, okay, let's think about it. How would Larry Page of Google think? How would Dominic Barton of McKinsey think? How would Jeff Bezos think about it? You know, how would Steve Jobs think about this situation? So you create personas that you believe in and you bring that person in the meeting and say, imagine if we were Jeff Bezos, if we were Dominic Barton or Larry Page or Satya Nadella, how would we think about this situation? How would we think about the business? And it's really interesting to observe because people come out of their identities and take a very powerful, successful identity at a much bigger and scalable level, and the ideas are of a different quality altogether. So try that out. It's called role storming. And then the third one really is thinking about the ideal competitor, your ideal best competitor. And what that means is, imagine you're sitting down with your team and you say, what would our best, ideal, strongest competitor thinking about this situation? How would they approach this? What will they do in this context? And as soon as you think about your most, not brutal, but most powerful, strongest, sharpest competitor, and then say, how would they be approaching this? I assure you, it does give you an edge in your thinking. It does accelerate the process of how we are thinking and what we are thinking about. So let me just recap it for you. Three things to be mindful of. Think of the thinking hats, the six colors, research it, learn more about it, but it surely provides a very good structure to people to think. The second is role storming. how would person XYZ think about this situation? What would they be doing? What would they be looking at? And then the third one is, what would my ideal, strongest, most powerful competitor do about this situation? What will they be coming up with? So once you apply these techniques, the process of creativity and innovation becomes truly exciting. Team enjoys it, you enjoy it, and most importantly, you come out of it with something truly revolutionary, defining, and something that gives you a solid step up. I hope that helps. Make sure you subscribe to this channel so that you're getting more practical ideas about your business, how to best engage your team, and how to get the best out of the capability that you have. So take care. We'll be in touch with you very soon.